Good morning, my name is Loyal Carvalho and I am from the ESG team, and today we'll be discussing about the topic LiFi. So what we understand by the word LiFi, you must be feeling that it is similar to the word Wi-Fi, but no, LiFi is a different topic which we will be discussing about. So these are the points that we will be covering under the LiFi topic. LiFi stands for light fidelity. So to start with the topics, we have here the introduction today, the working, how LiFi works, what are the different features of LiFi, what are the different advantages and impacts that LiFi has in our daily life, the LiFi comparison with the Wi-Fi. So what different is LiFi from Wi-Fi? What are the advantages LiFi holds over Wi-Fi? What are the limitations LiFi has over Wi-Fi? We'll be discussing that. Then apart from that, the future scope of LiFi, we'll be trying to understand what LiFi would be bringing to us in future and how far we can take it ahead. So to tell you about LiFi, LiFi is a concept which was discussed in 2011 at a TED talk by Mr. Harold Hass. So Professor Harold Hass is a part of the Edinburgh University, and he came up with this concept of light fidelity. Light fidelity is extending the Wi-Fi, that is wireless fidelity, to another level. So we know Wi-Fi. Wi-Fi is basically used to access internet. So to understand LiFi, we should understand what are the different ways in which internet is basically used. So as we all know, the different ways in which internet, we have been accessing our dial-up, then we have wireless communication, wireless, that is Wi-Fi. Then we have LAN, wherein we have a cable inserted into our computer device. And apart from that, we have the future scope of extending this, that is the LiFi. So before understanding what LiFi exactly is, we will understand about what the whole concept of Wi-Fi was. So the Wi-Fi concept works basically on radio waves. So data transmission that happens over radio waves, using radio waves frequency, is what is wireless fidelity, that is Wi-Fi, is how it operates. So you have Wi-Fi access points. These are Wi-Fi access points that are stationary in a particular room or in a particular area. So that particular area allows access to the regions and to the users of those in those boundary, so that they can access internet. And you have an option even to connect to the LAN. So we have the wireless LAN and we have the Wi-Fi facility. So basically you have a device which allows radio waves to transmit data, and thereby Wi-Fi is connected to the access point, and thereby we connect to the internet. So Wi-Fi allows many users to interact with a single access point, and thereby you can access the internet. So what is LiFi exactly? Now, LiFi is transmission of data using light. Here we spoke about radio waves. So light has a huge bandwidth of spectrum. So because the bandwidth of spectrum is so large, the transmission rate at which data will go is also large. So the main advantage here would be the transmission of data, that is the peak data rates would increase tremendously. That is, compared to Wi-Fi, the data rate would increase almost 1,000 times. So we could allow access to internet on a very large scale and a very large speed. So here we're talking about speed which is close to 10 GB per second. So currently Wi-Fi allows data speed or data transmission at a rate of 2.4 GHz. And they have come up with a concept called Wi-Fi Halo, which would extend that to 5 GHz. But that is something which is restricted to a particular limitations. So the main thing in Wi-Fi that limits its capabilities is, if the number of users increases in Wi-Fi, it would obviously have an impact on the rate at which data is transmitted. So if we have a large number of users in a particular room who are accessing the Wi-Fi, so that would thereby decrease the rate of transmission of data. So thereby it would result in slow speeds of internet. But LiFi allows you to access data based on the light transmission. So if you have any light source, so that could be an LED bulb, or it could be any source of light that is emitting an illumination of light that could be used to transmit data. So to understand more about Li-Fi, let's learn about the working of Li-Fi.
Okay.
So this diagram basically depicts what Li-Fi would actually be working as. So you have a lamp over here. A lamp basically that illuminates light. So this LED light that is illuminating light towards the dongle over here, that is capable of allowing data to be transmitted to the downstream devices that we have. So how does this actually come into picture? So what happens is you have a source of particular electronic device that would be able to generate light. So this light would be having signal processing ability. So when you say signal processing ability, it would transmit light in a direction that is downstream. So whatever device, the dongle that is receiving the data, would transmit that into a data stream, and that data stream would thereby go and you could use it for your device. So that device could be a mobile device, it could be a computer, it could be a laptop. So basically the light would transmit the energy signal process and convert it into data, which could be used for the electronic device to stream a video or anything. So the important factor that differentiates Li-Fi from Wi-Fi is that light when it passes through an object, it can the rate at which light passes, it can fluctuate. So that is how Li-Fi can actually be controlled. So suppose if we are streaming a video, and if I keep an obstacle in between that, so that light wouldn't transmit across that obstacle. It would limit its scope to pass through that obstacle. So that means Li-Fi has its scope of being able to, it can only be transmitted within boundaries. So why would that be an advantage? So basically, if you know Wi-Fi operates over a bandwidth of different areas. So if you see that it can surpass the walls, it can surpass a wall, it can surpass an obstacle. If I connect a Wi-Fi over here, so that means that the data can be leaked across the boundaries of the walls. Whereas in Li-Fi, you have a light emitting source in one room, and that would limit its capabilities, its transmission of data to that room itself. So if you want, we can ensure security in that way. So if there's any kind of access that you need to have of data, so that could be limited to that particular area itself. So that would allow us to have high security for data, and it would prevent data leakage. So basically it allows the fluctuation of the light to thereby impact the rate at which data is transmitting. So if you have a high fluctuating or high transmission of light through the device, that would thereby increase the rate at which the data would be transmitting. So thereby, if you want to increase the data rate, that would mean ki we would want to actually enhance the light source that we are gaining it from. So why light instead of Wi-Fi? What it would be an advantage, basically? So clearly, right now we are seeing a lot of energy sources going from traditional sources of energy to natural sources of energy. We have solar light, we have solar power, which is being used extensively across the world. So in future, we can see this concept being implemented a lot in our day-to-day applications, and as well as in our surroundings, because the source of light, if natural source of light could be harnessed for this, that means it would allow the transmission of data freely to everyone, and it would not prevent the accessibility of data to to particular users in particular areas. So basically, if you have solar light harnessed, and if we replace this by a solar power emitting light source, that could thereby increase the capacity of data transmission. Thereby, the knowledge would become free. It would be natural source of light that could be used. So it is estimated that around 50 billion people would be using would be needing the use of internet by 2020. So obviously that number would be a large number to fill in, because if we would require that much amount of energy consumption to actually be generated and to actually be able to produce that amount of energy for those amount of users. So this could be a very good application in the future, and looking at the kind of advantages that it has, it can be implemented in a lot of day-to-day usages. So some of the important features that Li-Fi has are directional lighting. Directional lighting would be lighting which focuses on a particular direction, thereby allowing enhancing data transmission only in that particular area. So what happens with Wi-Fi is, the range or the bounds to which internet or data transmission takes place is spread. So thereby what happens is a lot of the signals are wasted. So what we can do is, in directional lighting using Li-Fi, is we can ensure that it is focused on one particular area. Then energy efficiency. This is a very important factor, since energy efficiency would allow us to thereby improve the energy efficiency by 1000 times. Since you are having a light emitting source which is already generating light and thereby using it for data transmission, so we are allowing dual purpose for one particular device. That would eventually save a lot of energy, and it would have a lot of advantages if we keep on technologically innovating in different fields of areas. Third would be intrinsic security. As I've already explained about the kind of security that Li-Fi would be able to provide, because the areas and the limitations that it covers, so thereby it would allow it to be a more secure and more robust kind of communication wireless service. Then high data rate capability, since we're using Li-Fi which would transmit at a very high speed, it would allow the data rate to be extensively 1000 times more than Wi-Fi. So that would be a very, very big advantage in terms of data transmission. Then signal blocking and integrated network capability. Again, the signal that is being sent from the device would be focused within those particular areas, so that could be used and applied in a lot of other areas, and it could be used in purposes where we need to ensure that our data is very secure, and we need to ensure that it's kept in a very there's not a lot of leakage in terms of data. So apart from that, the advantages and applications, since in today's times the use of internet has spread across a lot of day-to-day activities, and we know a lot of Internet of Things technologically has advanced to so many things that we can use the light emitting source to be able to extensively use in the household appliances. So if you have our normal light emitting source which would allow us data transmission, that would allow basically communication between two different sources, and thereby allow them to communicate and enhance the kind of features that we can use for these applications or appliances. Then since light can travel through water, so that means it will allow underwater communication as well. So that is something which is a very big advantage. If you need to communicate through water, Li-Fi would be a boon for such an extensive areas of expertise where you have where research is done in the oceans to understand what exactly is there in the ocean bed. So underwater communication would be an area where Li-Fi would be really useful. Apart from that, intelligent transport system. So most of our vehicles have LED lights, if you LED lights, so those lights can be enhanced and can be made smarter, so that you have an integrated transport system which is intelligent, so that the two so that vehicles having those lights can communicate with each other and the transport system could be efficient. That would imply having anti-collision systems wherein you have two vehicles which are so smart enough to communicate with each other using the Li-Fi that they could prevent an accident. Then localized advertising. Localized advertising would refer to advertising wherein we have the use of maybe a light emitting dashboard or a billboard which is used as a knowledge source as well, because since we already having a light emitting advertising board, we can use it for purposes of data transmission in different ways and allow it to use for advertising. So apart from that, the limitations to Li-Fi would be that it is an area of still research. I mean, there have been a lot of companies that are trying to bring this into implementation, but it is still in a phase of research yet, and we could expect this to come in the next 3 or 5 years. The other limitation would be the range, since we are speaking about it being bound to a particular area. So that means that it could be only accessible to a particular area that is emitting light. So for that, we can consider that as one of the limitations. So overall, it's a very futuristic concept which can be implemented in the next 5 years, and we could see a different future for ourselves wherein we are having Li-Fi alongside Wi-Fi, and we could see a different range of internet usage of internet through wireless communications and other services like Li-Fi. So that's it. Thank you.